issues of the emerging church. What's been happening on that scene since you were here last?
The emerging church?
Yes.
Well, a lot has been happening since. How many of you were here last time for our emerging church symposium? Okay, quite a few. Yes, so we talked about the inroads into how it's entering Adventism. A lot has been happening since then. Too much to talk about in 1 minute. But yeah. A lot's been happening, but this is still God's church, and a lot of good things has also been happening in God's church since then.
Thanks. Now, Janet, you've been associated with that program as well. Would you like to tell us why you got involved with it?
Well, the first part of me getting involved in speaking on some of these issues had to do with the One Project. Most of you have heard about the One Project. It's been around here for several years in several different venues. And when the One Project people started coming from the university, Walla Walla University, near where I live, down to the academy level, and started approaching my grandchildren to get involved, that's when I decided to get involved and speak up.
Yes, so Janet's been part of the symposiums that have been happening in various places.
Since the very beginning.
Since the very beginning. How many of you know Janet from ADTV? They're all your friends, Janet.
Hi.
please come and say hello. Janet hasn't met any of you because she can't see through the television screen. So folks come up to Janet and greet her as though they've long lost relatives, don't they, Janet?
That's right. Yeah. I'd like to meet you all.
So you're part of the family too. You're welcome to come and do that. Janet, what's your background? Were you a theologian? Did you?
No. I'm a mom and a grandmother, and chose to stay home with my children once my children came along. And I didn't look for a career, even though I could have had one. I chose to be the mother and stay home with my children. And then after a few years and the children were grown, and I stayed home and took care of my mother and my mother-in-law, who each needed care for about 15 years. And so all of a sudden I'm retired, and then career is not the operative thing for me. So no, I'm not a theologian. I'm not a pastor. I'm not ordained. I'm just a mom and a grandma. I'm a laity, just like almost everybody else here.
Amen.
So I don't know if it was coincidental or providential, but a week before our program was to start in Melbourne, there was a very special event in Janet's life, which was.
Well, my son married an Australian girl in Melbourne just before we started this trip up north. It was my first trip to Australia, and when I got a call saying, can we tack on some speaking appointments onto the week of time that you're spending in Melbourne for the wedding, I said, sure, that would be great. And so I had the feeling I might get back to Australia again since we have family now in Australia.
Now, it was more than just marrying into an Australian family. Are there any folks here who are Romanians? Or not? Okay, because the Australian family that Janet married, son married into, just happened to be Romanians
as
well.
Romanians, yes.
So it was quite an occasion, and it's. We're so grateful that God opened up this opportunity for Janet to be here. Diamond, since you went back to Hawaii, you were 17 years of age when you were there. He had his 20th birthday while he was here with us last week.